This message this morning is for those who are having a difficult time in any relationship that they're in. The Bible gives you a promise of comfort, and it is found in Psalm 126. And here's what the scripture says. Those who sow in tears shall reap in joy. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. Now you say, what does that mean for me? Well, it means that if you are doing what God tells you to do, if you are sowing or investing or putting in the right actions, the right words, the right emotions, the prayers into your relationship, even if your spouse is not requiting your love, even if you are being misunderstood, even if you may be married to an unbeliever, the Bible says that you should continue sowing or putting in that which is right. Sowing is a metaphor for investing. When a farmer goes out and sows seed into the soil, he's putting in something with the expectation of harvest. Well, this is what God is telling you. When you sow into your relationship, even if you're doing it with tears in your eyes, morning by morning, evening by evening, it's difficult. Afternoon by afternoon, it's difficult. Even if this is with your children or with someone else that you are in relationship with, God says you continue sowing. You continue putting in what is right in God's sight. And the Bible has a promise for you this morning. He who continually goes forth weeping. You see that? You're going forth. You're continually doing this. It is not that you did it once. This could be many years now. It could be many weeks, several days of misunderstanding, of pain. Whatever you are enduring, the Bible says, he who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. This is the power of God's word. And the promise tells us that if you keep doing what you're doing, even if you're not seeing results right now, even if people are saying you're a fool for staying with that man or that woman, even if people are saying, oh, you got to get out of there, you got to do something better with your life, even if you are feeling those things and the pain is intense, the Bible says if you continue doing what God has called you to do, you continue going forth, even with weeping, bearing seed, precious seed, seed for sowing. And that seed is so important. That seed must be what God has put into your heart. It must be prayer. It must be the word of God. It must be a loving action, a kind deed. It's not preaching in your relationship or telling your spouse often. If they're an unbeliever, telling them why they should repent, that's the wrong seed. You've got to bring in the right seed. And the right seed is what God gives you as a Holy Spirit. That's the seed. That you shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing your sheaves with you. What are sheaves? Sheaves are harvest. That's what you're harvesting. That's what you're bringing in. That's what you're going to come home with, rather. You're putting in the right words, the right deeds. You're being faithful. You're being loving. You're being obedient. You're seeking wisdom. And what happens? God brings forth a harvest. God brings forth a harvest. And the promise is there will be a harvest. There will be a harvest. There will be sheaves that you will bring in. There will be a time in your relationship for rejoicing. The Bible says, he who goes forth bearing seed for sowing shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. You see, there's a time for sowing and there's a time for reaping. And one of the greatest promises in God's word is, as a man sows, so shall he reap. And so if you keep doing what God tells you to do, despite the pain, despite the misunderstanding, despite the years of resentment or contempt, stick it out, brothers and sisters. Stay in the field and wait for the harvest. Have faith in God. And faith means living in faithful expectation. You see, faith, I translate that into the words L-I-F-E, living, L, in faithful expectation. And you are trusting God and believing God's word that if you keep doing what's right in his sight, God will bring a harvest of joy. So today, if you're in a battle, trust God. If you're being misunderstood, keep sowing the right thing. If it is not going the way you think it ought to be, keep doing what God tells you to do, because God is the God of the harvest. And he is the one who will say, one day you will see that seed become fruit, and it will be the fruit of the Spirit in your relationship. Amen.